68% of Americans have less than $1,000 in savings. Is this you? Well, by the end of this video, you will know exactly how to save $1,000 as fast as possible. My name is Carmen.
And I'm Darius. And for, like Carmen said, 58% of us, $1,000 in savings could be daunting. It's because of some of the habits that we've created to get ourselves to this point.
Yep.
And in this video, we're going to break down some of those tips so that you can put yourself in a better position to not just save $1,000, but save even more.
Exactly. So let's go ahead and just have this conversation first, can we? I hate when people call your savings an emergency fund. This is not an emergency fund, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want you to think in a scarcity mindset, because if you're always saying, oh, my emergency fund, you're projecting that something is going to happen, that an emergency could probably happen. So let's just change the gate. You know, we're gonna think positively. Let's call it an opportunity fund, shall we? Because this opportunity fund allows us the opportunity to pay for things if they come up. So we're just gonna change our mindset, change those few words around. So this opportunity fund that we're gonna teach you how to build is gonna be a game changer for you, which is gonna help you sleep more soundly at night, knowing that you actually have a plan in place and you have some cushion in case something comes up.
Now, the first tip that we wanna give you is that people that don't have money, what they want more than anything is to have money.
Yes.
So what do they do instead? In the absence of money, they look like they have money. So it's a starch comparison to those that have money. A lot of people that we know, they look like they don't have money, if that makes sense. So the rich people are trying to look poor and the poor people are trying to look rich. Now, it's much easier for you to be rich and look like you're poor than it is for you to be poor and look like you're rich. Because what happens is, if you don't have money, you get into debt and you start thinking wrong about the financial decisions that you make because you want to look to part. So in this first tip, you have to react to your finances according to where you are financially. You shouldn't be going into debt to get a Gucci bag to look like you have Gucci money when you don't. So what you want to do is make financial decisions based on your level so that you can start setting aside money to put yourself in a better position to make more money in the future. It's all about delayed gratification.
And to that point, with people who actually have money, their perspective is different. So they're maybe not running out to buy Gucci bags because their value lies in different things. They may be putting that towards investments or things that actually make them money as opposed to spending money. So the second step that we want to share with you is actually something tangible. When it comes to saving money, putting money aside, we always talk about paying yourself first. And that can be maybe a little bit of a complex thing to think about. How am I going to pay myself? But I'm going to challenge you in this video right now. If you have $50, separate that $50 from your checking account and put it in your savings account. And how quickly can you do that until you get to $1,000, right? Because if you're going to spend money on that Gucci bag or your electricity bill or Netflix or Hulu or whatever it is, realize that you're literally taking your money and you're giving it to that person, you're giving it to this person, you're giving it to that person. You're literally giving your money away.
Literally.
Do you understand that? You're literally giving your money away. And if you're gonna give your money away, then send it this way, you know, because we'll figure out a way to do something with it.
Yeah, at least join our Patreon page where we talk about finances and different opportunities that you can maybe use right now to put yourself in a better financial position.
Exactly,
because
to empower yourself.
The biggest asset that you have is you.
Yes.
And if you're gonna give away money, the best thing to do is utilize that money to put yourself in a position to learn more about finances and how it works so that you can start applying the knowledge that you have to start investing, to start creating different sources of income, just to start making more money.
Exactly. So when we're talking about your finances, whatever money that you have right now, start putting it aside and do it consistently. You know, some people will put like a few $100 aside and then they stop because they think that they're good. Figure out the amount that you want to put aside and do it consistently until you get to $1,000. To get to that milestone, breathe, celebrate, have an amazing time, and just think about that's $1,000 that you put aside for you. Mm-hmm. You didn't give it away to anybody else. You just put it aside for yourself.
Now, the third thing that we want to talk about is take a look at the previous 90 days of your bank statement. take a look and see what are you spending your money on. What can you categorize your biggest expenses and even some of your small expenses? Because those small expenses are really what adds up. And you know, we might have a credit card that may be $50 a month. But if we have five of those credit cards, that's $250 that we're spending just on different credit card expenses, that most of that money is going towards interest.
Exactly.
So it's really important that we look at the previous 90 days of our bank statement so we can see exactly where our money is going, so we can start making some mental notes of how we can start changing that to put ourselves in a better position to start putting some of that money aside.
Exactly. And to Darius's point, definitely click on the link below and check out our course, The Money Blueprint, because The Money Blueprint is all about teaching you financial literacy, because we want to increase your financial intelligence so that you know how to allocate your funds, you know how to take advantage of opportunities that come, and of course, what we're all here for, infinite banking, so that you can apply all your hard work and your savings towards creating your own banking system so that you can create wealth and opportunity for your family. Now, the last point that I want to share with you is, we talked about checking out your bank statements. What I want you to do is, with every single purchase that you make, every time you swipe your card, I want you to ask yourself one question before you swipe that. And that question is gonna be, do I need this? Be honest with yourself. Do I need this? Going to Starbucks? No, that's not a necessity. Buying frivolous things? No, that's not a necessity.
Buying junk food? No, it's not a necessity, because it doesn't increase your well-being. Mm-hmm. Matter of fact, it may make it worse in some cases if it's like Twinkies.
Yeah, that can make your health poor. Now you got high health bills. So if anything, what we want to do is just start getting you into perspective, because sometimes it's just so easy to swipe these days. Take a moment, and every single time you go to swipe or spend some cash, just ask yourself, do I need this? And if the answer is no, then take that money and put it aside towards your opportunity fund. Drop whatever it is that you're about to buy and transfer that money to your opportunity fund.
Right. And it's really important that we ask ourselves this question, because a lot of times when it comes to money, we make emotional decisions. Mm-hmm. When you take a look at the marketing that we get, the commercials of brand new cars, the commercials are created so that we have some type of emotional attachment to this particular product or service. Mm-hmm. And whenever we have an emotional connection to it, we don't make logical decisions.
No.
So we want to intentionally make logical decisions every time we spend money. Is this going to be adding value to me? Is this going to increase my net worth? What is it doing for me? Do I need it?
Yeah. Is it getting me closer to my financial goals? And do you even have financial goals to begin with? That's a whole nother thing that you should be asking yourself. Because by the end of this year, what are some things that you want to accomplish financially? Good question.
Right. Now, when it comes to saving that your first $1,000, it's really important that you take all these tips into consideration so that you can put yourself in that ideal position to have that $1,000 sitting in your savings account so that you can move on to the next step, which is maybe some investing in yourself. You have to have a good foundation of saving to get there. Mm-hmm. And the habits that you create along the way of creating that $1,000 in your savings is very important to help you move forward throughout your financial journey.
Exactly. And once you get to that $1,000, ladies and gentlemen, the key is to not spend it. Again, we're not going to give that money away. We're going to keep it for ourselves, and we're going to continue to build it. Don't spend that money. Allow yourself to create opportunities so that you can make money with this money. It's not about spending it. It's about using this as an opportunity to invest, to make money, and to further your financial goals.
Make sure you like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and hit the notification bell so that you can be notified when we post our next video.
Exactly. And check out our course, The Money Blueprint, where you can learn how to take control of your finances and own your own lifestyle.
Remember to own your own lifestyle.
Or someone else will.